Hello and welcome back to Let's Play the Charnel House Trilogy. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now beginning Sepulchre, I believe. You guys have to watch the previous episode, especially the very end, to know what's going on.
And the wicked shall hold their tongues.
Because I still don't know what's going on, and I played through it.
They stir. Beneath this silent world of saints and sinners, twixt the living and the dead.
Is he reading that book?
Train's still going. Can't have slept long. We left. When did we leave?
Oh, where
did we leave?
Where do we leave?
God damn. It's unnervingly quiet. Maybe I should fetch some water. Restaurant should be open now.
Well, the restaurant in the train, on the train. Okay. So here is the book that he was reading that Alex gave to him last episode. There is a luggage with a human being on board. Who I loaded by who? We're playing as this guy. I forget his name. But he's a... apparently a historian or archaeologist or something like that. Hold on one second. Sorry about that. Maybe I'll remember to edit that out. Windows wants to restart and I am not restarting right now. I am playing something. So let's look at stuff.
I don't want to be carting a book around unnecessarily. The Charnel House Burial by Louis Cassel. To think I don't get enough of the dead without pulp horror novels. Just one vice.
That's why I think he is an archaeologist, although he didn't specifically say. So he's going to be looking for digging and looking for pots and stuff like that?
It's nothing interesting. I can't just cart around any old thing.
Why not? It's an adventure game.
Shutters down.
Open it.
Shutters down.
I clicked to open it. Oh.
No use. Stuck.
Okay.
Comfy enough to sleep on, evidently. Comfy enough to... comfy en...
comf... Okay, so all that's left is the door to look at. Book. Alright.
It's nothing interesting.
Oh wait, what's there? Hold on.
Not without my wallet. What do we have here then? Wallet. Yes. Dr. Lang.
Harold
curator
Lang?
Of the Crenicon Thames Museum. That's me, all right.
Oh. That's where she got a, Alex from the previous episode got a phone call, something an invitation to the Crenicon Thames Museum.
It's nothing interesting. No sense in taking the entire thing.
Alright. Wallet and museum ID card.
Ah, a bit of money. Just what the doctor ordered. Dr. Harold Lang.
Yeah.
Krennic on Thames Museum. Badge ID CCPN 1318.
Good to know.
A crisp £5 note. It's my credit card.
It sure is. Alright, let's go.
Let's go stir up a drink or two. Maybe something strong is in order. Clear the head. Okay, I'm Dr. Harold Lang. My destination is Augur Peak Island. I'm on this train to...
is that to say... he has to remind himself?
I'm going to evaluate some finds. They called me to...
Maybe he needs the inhaler.
A painting of a train. Is it this one? No, looks too old. Maybe an ancestor.
Heh.
A painting of an old train. I don't think the ticket inspector would be too happy with me if I took it. It's nothing interesting.
Time to put out some fires.
I can't just cart around any old thing.
Hmm. Can he go right back in? That's what I want to know. He can, okay.
Locked. I can't hear anyone inside. Locked.
Exit right. One A.
Locked. Locked.
I can't.
A friendly looking fellow. Makes a change for public transport.
Now, is he the guy who let us on the train, who just has a guy in a bag and killed a crow and stuffed it in his coat?
Good evening, my friend. I was wondering if you could...
Ah, yes. I've seen you poking around. Having trouble settling down, are we?
I beg your pardon?
Something like that. Could do with a stiff drink about now?
Right you are, then.
Well, I guess I can ask about the painting.
That painting on the wall.
Isn't she a beaut? Runs like clockwork, so she does.
It's...
What?
This train. Isn't it a little old?
You kids today have got no appreciation of machinery.
We've got to be the same age at best.
Well, practically grew up in her, so I did. There's nothing about old Gloria that I don't know.
Hmm. Confirmed, we're on the ghost train.
A friend.
Right you are, then.
Alright. I guess we're exiting stage right.
Locked?
Oh.
Isn't this the way out? Locked?
Yo, let me out of here.
Right you are, then.
Keyhole?
The door to the next carriage appears to be locked. Is that normal? Nothing's wrong, is it?
You city folks always jump to conclusions. There's nothing wrong. It's just how we do things when our guests are asleep. It prevents prying eyes and swift fingers.
Isn't that a bit of a fire hazard?
Extinguisher.
Let me tell you. If a fire breaks out in this train, then no amount of carriage doors are going to save you from roasting. If you catch my drift. Be a steel coffin if the unthinkable happened.
Great.
Could you possibly unlock the door? I could really use a drink.
Don't reckon I can, no.
Hey.
Can give you the key, though. On one condition.
What's that?
Please don't tell me he's going to ask me to solve some ridiculous conundrum of his.
Bring me back a shot of whiskey when you get back. Old Floyd will hook you up. Just tell him it's for Don.
Don.
No problem, my friend. Thank you.
For Don, got it. So I guess it flashes up top when we get something in inventory is what it is.
It's a key.
Really?
Bring me back a shot of whiskey when you get back. Old Floyd will hook you up. Just tell him it's for Don.
But you're on duty, sir. What if I try to use the key on, like, here?
Not really something I want to try. Not really.
Yeah, it's unlocked, though. It's my own carriage.
Locked? Aha! Open.
Just wanted to see if it would do it automatically.
A A solemn-looking young woman. She's seated on a chair.
And covered by text.
Her eyes are staring off at something just outside the picture's edge. It's a little unnerving. I feel like I've seen a photograph like this before. If this wasn't up in a train carriage... A solemn-looking young woman. She's a little unnerving. It's bad enough looking at the picture, let alone carrying it around. Better hurry to the restaurant. Don't want it to close before I can get Don's whiskey. Not really. I can't just cart around any old thing. It's nothing interesting.
Okay, guys.
Locked. Damn.
Same key?
No good. I can't even get the key in. Must be locked from the other side.
What? How am I gonna get to the restaurant?
Locked.
Can I jimmy it with the credit card?
No. Not really something I want to try.
Well, crap. I must report failure, my good man.
The restaurant is locked. This key's no good.
Ah. Floyd must be getting things ready. Just take your time, boy. Let him do his thing. He'll unlock it when he's good and ready. There's no rush, is there?
I'm in an awful rush, sir. I need to get my drink on. But I just heard something unlock, so let's go this way. That time I didn't have to use it. Ooh, that's open though. Is this still locked?
Locked. I can hear movement from within. Something rustling.
They didn't say that out loud for some reason. Would it be rude to go in? Yes, it would, but this is an adventure game and we explore everything. Oh, you're the creepy guy who hangs out on Alex's couch sometimes. So we've got a bag. We've got grub. How funny, he doesn't look like food.
Shuttered and sealed. Just like in my room. Shuttered and sealed. A huge black hold all. Looks very heavy. God knows what's inside.
Is that the person's inside? A writer?
This isn't mine. I probably shouldn't even touch it. Grabbing other people's luggage is a bit of a faux pas.
Just a bit. Alright, so we've got paintings that don't interest me at this time.
A beautifully polished wooden box. It has a red, teardrop-shaped gem set into the top.
I'll just take that then.
I can't just go grabbing someone else's most prized possessions.
Oh, come on.
He doesn't look very well. That's if it's even a he. He looks positively sick, in fact. Hello there. I'm sorry for the intrusion. I was just...
Oh, God.
He's muttering something. I can't make it out. I'm sorry? What was that?
You're supposed to be afraid of this.
Maybe I should be going. I'm sorry to have bothered you. He doesn't seem to be able to open his mouth properly.
Oh, God.
I think I'd better leave. Maybe I should mention this to that ticket inspector.
You're supposed to be afraid by this guy. Worm food? He's worm food. I got an achievement unlocked for worm food. Oh, jeez.
He doesn't look very well. I can't... This isn't mine. Shuttered.
Okay, I guess we're leaving.
Locked. Damn.
Oh, the key is gone.
Not.
Keep thinking I could, like, stick the card in there.
Not.
Nope.
Locked. I think I can hear breathing inside. Faint sound of someone sleeping, perhaps. I won't disturb them further.
How you will disturb them?
Locked. Locked.
Alright, maybe not.
Locked. Locked.
We weren't listening before, now we're hearing sounds of someone sleeping inside. That's different. Can I look at anything in the picture? So that we, no. Okay.
It's nothing interesting. I can't. Mm-hmm. Locked.
Anything in my room?
Shutters down. No use. Stuck.
You know what though? Here, try it with this.
Not really so. Not.
And I doubt this, but.
Not.
Alright, never mind.
I can't just cut. It's nothing. Comfy enough. Come. No, sir. It's.
No, I'm done then.
It's.
Alright.
A painting of a train. A painting of an old. Lock. A friendly looking fellow.
Grub.
There's a man in one of the rooms in the next carriage. I don't think he's at all well.
In fact, he's probably dead.
We get some right crazies on the train sometimes, I'm telling you. You learn to leave them be after a while.
The wretched man can barely speak.
Aye. And I'd be the same way after the amount of booze most of these boys have had. Is Floyd still not operating then?
Right. Not as far as I'm aware.
Ah, well. Give the boy time. Hey. So one of your fellow passengers popped their head at the room at the end of the corridor. Maybe you'd get a better conversation out of her. Pretty little thing, so she was.
Alex.
Thanks. Are you sure that she was...
What? Narcolepsy. Interesting.
A friendly looking...
Okie dokie.
The door's slightly ajar.
Oh, what a coincidence.
Well, this was the right room. Hello?
Is she behind the luggage or something? Paper dogs?
It's nothing interesting. I can't just... It's nothing... I can't just...
A gunja.
Shuttered and sealed. Just like in my room. Shuttered...
Huge bag, paper dogs.
More large bags. Something doesn't feel right about this. They're all the same. Why would everyone have the same luggage? I want to have a look inside, but these are somebody's bags.
Yeah, I mean... I assumed this was Alex's room.
More large bags. Something doesn't feel right about this. They're all the same. Why would everyone have the same luggage? I want to have a look. A pile of paper dogs. They're not very well made.
Hmm.
As a child, I used to make origami like this. Where's the girl that ticket collector claims to have seen? I'm sure she won't miss just one.
I don't remember him.
Could she be... Nothing.
Huh.
But that sounded awfully like a door unlocking in the next carriage. Is Floyd ready for business?
Well, I don't want Alex to be dead.
I think I'll call him Sam.
Splendid.
It's nothing interesting.
Guy's still sleeping.
A friendly looking fellow.
I was trying the quick thing.
Locked. Locked. I don't think I should go back in there just yet.
Yeah. Not in the mood to talk to old Grub, how about you? Well, he can't view the door, look at that.
Food's getting cold. I haven't heard any sort of dinner bell. Are we supposed to just know when it's dinner time? Are any of these places for me, I wonder?
Wouldn't they... you ask for the food and then they serve it?
Food's getting cold. Shuttered and sealed. Shuttered... Not really... Not...
Yeah, we're not supposed to be able to see...
Food's getting cold.
Out the doors, obviously. Ah! Reminds me of The Shining here. Floyd. Bar.
Nicely stocked. Just the way I like it. They've got a pretty good range, considering this is a train.
Hmm.
Nicely stocked. He doesn't look too happy. I wouldn't either, if none of my dinner guests had shown up. Kind of a creepy fellow. And coming from someone who works in a museum, that's saying a lot.
What was that? Nothing? What's up, Floyd?
Good evening. Floyd, is it?
Ah, Mr. Lang, how nice of you to join us.
It's Dr. Lang, actually. But who needs formalities in a place like this?
Quite. I suppose you're here on business?
Business?
A drink, Mr. Lang, that is what you're after, is it not?
Perhaps a bite to eat first?
Unfortunately, all our meals are reserved. By all means, have a drink, though. Pull up a stool.
I'd better not stay. Your ticket collector, Don, I think it was, has tasked me with procuring him a glass of whiskey.
Ah, yes, he did leave his hip flask here, thinking about it. It's right there on the bar. This one's on the house, Mr. Lang.
Flask, okay. On the house.
A handy hip flask. The initials KD are etched into the side.
KD Lang?
Huh. It's empty.
Well, yeah, you're supposed to fill it with the whiskey he wanted.
A handy hip flask. Flask's empty, Floyd. Better give me a shot of whiskey.
No more freebies, I'm afraid, Mr. Lang. That'll be £5.
What?
£5? You're burying me alive here.
What's this noise? Is it getting louder?
No more
I don't think so. Nicely stocked. Not really.
No more freebies, I'm afraid, Mr. Lang.
Oh, we have money.
Here you go, my good man.
What's that noise?
Better hit me with another.
Excess is the path to ruin, Mr. Lang. We wouldn't want you to go before your time, would we?
I think I can manage just one more drink.
What?
That's what they all say, isn't it, Mr. Lang? Just one more for the road? I can handle it. Never had difficulty driving before.
I'm on a train.
What about your liver, Mr. Lang? Can that handle just one more drink?
You're not my
God
physician.
Damn, Floyd, you always were a preachy son of a bitch, weren't you?
I
always?
Think you're quite mistaken, Mr. Lang. We've never met, you and I. I just don't want you to do yourself an injury.
I can handle one more goddamn drink, you stupid bitch. Just stay out of my way, and I'll stay out of yours.
Oh, damn.
That's right, Mr. Lang. Let it all out. There's a good little puppy.
Well, that game with the dog references.
What the hell? What did... Shit.
Now, the bartender in The Shining, is his name Lloyd, right?
I need to go, Floyd. It's been a pleasure, as always.
Aren't you forgetting your promise, Mr. Lang? Whiskey. For Dawn.
I tried that. It's getting loud.
Whiskey. For Dawn.
A whiskey bottle. Looks expensive. Once more unto the breach, dear friends.
I'm afraid you can't just take it, Mr. Lang, no matter how much you wish to.
What?
How much?
It's not cheap, I'm afraid. £40 should do it.
I don't have that much money on me.
I'm sure you'll find a way, Mr. Lang. You always do.
I do?
Not really something I want to try. I don't think so. Not. Once more,
I'm afraid you
How much?
It's not...
I don't have that much.
I'm sure you'll...
Hold on. Well, that guy's name is Lloyd in The Shining, isn't he? The Shining... Lloyd! Yeah! Played by Joe Turkle, the Lloyd the creepy bartender in the 1980 horror film The Shining. Well, that music stopped, or that sound, whatever the hell it was. Got tired of waiting for me, I guess. I don't know what to do with this, actually. We need to fill... Is it full?
A handy hip flask.
Oh, can I pay for it with a paper dog?
I don't think so.
Oh, I can use my credit card. Just like a real American.
Okay, here goes. Goodbye, bank balance.
If you just enter your PIN.
Oh, what is that again?
Now, what was my PIN? I remember setting a number I can identify easily. No good with memorizing numbers. To Harold Lang.
1318, thank you.
Okay.
If you just...
Ta-da.
All done.
Thank you, Floyd.
No, thank you, Mr. Lang.
Alright, Lloyd. I mean, Floyd.
A whiskey bottle. Looks expensive.
Now we can combine items. Are you kidding? The entire thing? I just spent £40 on this guy's drink. For giving me the key to get into the next carriage for the door beyond that that was locked anyway because he hadn't opened yet? Gotta be kidding me.
A handy hip flask.
This is highway robbery, Floyd.
No, thank you, Mr. Lang.
No, screw you, Floyd.
Food's getting cold.
Yeah, who are these reserved for? Ghosts?
What the hell is happening to me? Oh, my head. I can't think.
Oh, Mr. Lang, that pale man you met. I think he just wants a best friend.
Oh, Grub?
Perhaps you're not quite what he's looking for? You are, after all, blind drunk.
Thanks.